insulation is a wonderful thing, especially in the wintertime. But when it comes to your computer, you want to have more breathability than a house built in the 1920s. All of the components in your computer produce heat. The CPU can run at 40 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius, and that's approximately 104 degrees Fahrenheit and 194 degrees Fahrenheit. And the graphics card can run anywhere between 50 degrees Celsius and 85 degrees Celsius, so 122 degrees Fahrenheit to 185 degrees Fahrenheit. Not to mention your hard drive, your RAM, your power supply, the SSD, all of these are going to be giving off heat as well. This is why your computer has so many fans in it, to pull in ambient air from the room that your computer is in, and to push out air from the computer itself. So let's loop back around here. When I say insulation in your computer, I'm not talking about the forbidden cotton candy from up in the attic. I'm talking about dust. Dust is the number one computer killer, and there's unfortunately no avoiding it. Most modern towers almost all come with some variant of filter near the intake fans. These are the ones that are at the front of the computer and usually along the top and the bottom of the power supply as well. The filters can reduce the amount of dust buildup that happens in your computer, but there's no way of eliminating it entirely. Not only does dust prevent proper airflow through your computer, thus increasing the heat, but it also gums up a lot of the works. All of the fan bearings, any moving parts that you have going on, getting into the fins of the CPU heatsink itself. Regularly inspecting your computer's filters and fans can only reduce the amount of dust buildup that is created. It can also extend your computer's life. I've seen computers from the 90s that still function as if they were just fabricated because of proper care and regular maintenance. Another thing that you can do, other than cleaning out the dust from your computer, is replacing the thermal compound that's on the CPU and on the graphics card die. Doing this ensures that you are keeping constant full contact with either that the die of the GPU or the heat spreader of the CPU. In next week's episode, I'm going to be showing you how to take these components apart and clean them out thoroughly. Until then, let me know what your questions are about computer maintenance in the comments down below. And if you liked this video, please do so and be sure to subscribe so that you don't miss the teardown build next week. Until then, I'm Waylon, this is XethaPCs.